just dismiss everything over here as being childish or childlike or pre-rational. They kind of snicker at the idea of church or God or anything because, of course, nights for children or weak people. And all we're trying to say is there are different levels, and the problem is once you get to the pre-rational level, you don't educate them or the next level, they might feel like it's convincing. If we can't explain it here, then if we can't explain it, it doesn't exist. It's not real. And, of course, faith is not pre-rational, but faith is trans-rational. It understands science. It includes science. How many used some science this morning? If you drove here, you used your brakes. There's some science. You use science all the time. It's not that you can't be one or the other. By transcending, you can use any one of these. You can dip into there anytime you need to. You transcend them and you include them, but you're at a different level where you start to see that there's more. There's more. I can't explain everything. I'm not going to understand everything. I'm going to have some faith. So, sight. Now today, of course, everybody's blaring all the time about science, and you get accused all the time of being non-scientific. That's not scientific. Not listening to the science. And what's the underlying thing there? Now, I'm not saying for or against, just listen. What's the underlying thing? Science, 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 science. It's always the accusation. The underlying thing is that that's the highest level. That's the highest level. Now, faith, transrational, Paul says we walk by faith, not by sight. This is not to dismiss science. It doesn't reject it. Remember the scripture that says, Abraham faced the fact. Faced the duty background checks is when I'm in jeans and got yourself a donut. Now, I don't know what other kids had good faith and credit I'm in jeans, but I just know if I was ever in need of a donut, just walk in and I was good. Faith is a very simple, simple thing. When you're here, just think for a minute. Life is very simple and pre-rational. It's very simple. And then life gets very complicated, doesn't it? I realize things are a lot more complicated than I thought. And here's the funny thing about faith. It gets real simple again. And actually, every one of you is craving this simplicity. Simple trust. I don't know how much this donut costs. I don't know what the tab is. I don't understand all the details of it. But I know that my Father will take care of it. I know he won't get there. My Dad will take care of it. That's why faith is such an important part, because it takes your life to another level. And I would just say this, I think it's a level that at some point everybody really craves. Disciples, they had to let go of their nets, right? Abraham later had to let go of his son Isaac. Mary had to let go of her reputation. Faith is always the letting go, so that your life can go to another level. Two parts of faith to think about. First, faith is not a one-time declaration, but faith is a daily decision. One-time declaration, this is my faith. That is to say, I am Methodist, I am Baptist, I am Catholic. This is my declaration. And you put a badge on, or you wear this shirt, or you get you fly their flag, and this is your faith. But that won't suffice. What you need is faith that is a daily part of your life, that weaves itself into how life works on Mondays. That's why a lot of people, they have faith, which is just a declaration, like, I'm Baptist, and they do it on Sunday, and that has nothing to do with Tuesday. Faith has to have everything to do with Tuesdays. It has to have the sense that you can trust God when things are falling apart on Friday. stop bleeding. It just kept coming and coming. That's how stress feels to some of you. It just comes and it comes and you're never. And so what you need is you need faith. Faith actually does something. Faith works in your life. Ready? Faith heals you. Faith heals you. If you think you can rationalize your way over everything, explain everything, figure everything, control everything, try it for a while. It's fun for a couple of years. Until you're completely stressed out. You can't control everybody, everyone's reactions. How many of you have ever had to say, you know, I'm surprised the way that person reacted to me. I thought you would have reacted this way if I took this action. Surely they would take this action and they surprise you a bit. You can't control how people react to you. But think about this. How many people are you going to meet in your life? How many interactions are you going to have at work, at school? And if happiness for you is controlling and knowing everyone's reactions to you, you are going to be one stressed out person. Faith just says, I have to take it as it comes. Faith is healing. Not long after that, Matthew writes about two blind men that come following Jesus and they say, Lord, have mercy on us. And Jesus says to them, do you believe that I am able? And they say, yes. And Jesus says, listen to this, according to your faith, let it be done to you. Here's the difference between a declaration of faith and a daily dependence of faith. Do you believe I'm able? There's a lot of people that believe in God. That's what I call the declaration. I'm Baptist, we believe in God. I'm Protestant, I'm Catholic. I believe in God, I believe that a God exists. But there's one thing to believe that there's a God that exists, and there's another thing to believe, just take the donut because they don't pay the bill. Just trust that He is involved, He will be there, He will show up for you. Big difference. The difference is faith as a daily part of your life. Far too many people are settling. Ready? For faith. They're just settling for faith as a something you hang on your wall. And faith is meant to be something that you carry with you throughout your day. Faith, by the way, is not like a means to an end. I have faith so I can get this, but faith is an end itself. That is to say, when you have faith, you're there. You're calm. You're trusting. It's okay. Sometimes things work out the way you want them to, right? And sometimes things work out the way you didn't. In either situation, you need what? Faith. Do you remember in the story in Daniel when they refused to bow down and to worship and they say, it doesn't matter if you throw us into this fiery furnace because our God can save us. Then they say this, but even if He doesn't, there's faith. Even if He doesn't, we still won't bow down. Faith is this understanding that I'm trusting that God's going to take care of me no matter what. And no circumstance, no disease, no illness, no economy, no politician, nothing can rattle that God's going to take care of me. Don't we have too many rattled people right now? Huh? Some of you could put your hand up because your hand is a rattle. Too many rattled people. As if God's going to just tilt right off. Boom. And it's amazing to me how many people do this in the name of God. They try to rattle everybody. Faith doesn't rattle people. Faith calms people. He gets in the boat and the storm is raging. And it's Jesus speaks to the storm and it becomes completely what? Calm. It's calm. I just don't see how rattling and screaming and I don't see how it's compatible with faith. Faith does something to you. It heals you. It soothes you. It calms
leads to a greater end. Faith is where you want to be. Because for the rest of your life, let's just be honest, there's going to be challenges, there's going to be problems. What's going to happen when you get through this particular problem? You just gear up for the next one. Is this true? Like, no, but I think when I turn 47, all my problems are going to go away. 47 is the number. I mean, you thought that way when you were young, right? I know once we get this job, once we get this house, then we're going to... What's reality? What's life? Is this that you roll through one and you roll into the next? So if you tie yourself to your circumstances, how people are treating you, how things are going, how the financial situation is, what the political climate is like, then if you tie yourself to that, what's going to happen to you in here? You're like this. But if you tie yourself to Christ, right? I think there's a reason that Jesus takes three of the disciples up to the mountaintop. The story in the Gospels is they get to the mountaintop and Jesus is transfigured before their eyes. They see like they had never seen before. Is it possible that there's more to see than your eyes can see? I mean, even science in recent years has shown us that there's more than your physical eye can see. And as the instruments get better and better and better, they start to realize there's so much more that we're not even close to being aware of. They're on the top of the mountain, and when Jesus is transfigured, life just becomes different up there. Now, you can't live your life on a mountain, I understand that, but I do believe this. You and I can start to learn to live by faith. It's actually translated walk by faith. That's to say, it's just that every step, I think walk is a good, every step, one step at a time. I'm trusting in God. Don't worry about what's down there. You hear what I'm saying? Where's all your worry? Where's all your stress? What's down there next Tuesday? What's going to happen next Tuesday? You don't know what's going to happen next Tuesday. Just worry about this step. Ready? And then you worry about this step and this step. And every step, you trust God. It's going to be okay. If you could imagine, ready? Like Imogene's donut shop. I mean, I don't know if anyone here is named Imogene, but that's a generation that, come on, Imogene. Imagine, right? This is, life is one big donut shop, right? There's plenty to go around. There's plenty to go around. Help yourself. And trust your Father will take care of it. He'll pay the bill. Share, because there's plenty to go around. Pour someone else's coffee. Don't just worry about your cup. Someone will come around and fill yours too. My cup runs over. Goodness and mercy will follow me. The problem with this is you're always trying to follow what is good. But when you're living by faith, it's following you. Someone will fill your cup. I think if we could just somehow allow ourselves so what he tried to do is he said, everybody that's here, anything that's beyond his level of understanding, that is transrational, that is spiritual, any spiritual state, is actually childish. And with one simple writing, he tried to dismiss every spiritual state. Now listen carefully to me. This spiritual state, people loving and trusting and caring, the ultimate donut shop, may I? may I stretch it a little further? Where people come in and, man, you know, if I've got $5 and my meal only costs $4, you can have the extra dollar for your donut. Where we don't need to count and keep track. Where it's, what I think Jesus called it, forgiving. Where the flow is there. What do you call the kingdom of God? But the secular is trying to pull you away and dismiss it all and say, that's all childish. I'd like to just commend to you. You need faith in your daily life. You don't necessarily need faith as a declaration to put on your door or a bumper sticker on your car. All that's fine and good if it helps you. But what you need is it needs to get internalized so you're a person that just trusts that you're open. You're open to the transcendent. You're open that when you don't know a way, God can make a way. Let's stand. We'll have a closing prayer. Dear God, I pray that you will open up our hearts and our minds. The work of your Spirit within us. And God, I pray for those who are struggling today, let them feel a sense of your grace. Let this prayer, this moment right now, be transcendent for them. That you're at work, that you're going to come pay the bill, that you will take care of them, that you're aware and that you're working for their behalf and for their good. God, give us the grace to let go. Let go of trying to control. Let go of trying to understand. Let go of trying to manipulate.